I love you. God is good.
Going through shame, but we don't know what really took place
of the cross, hallelujah. There's so much more that took place on the cross, hallelujah. There's so much more that took place on the cross. He became our sin so that he became sin so that we can become the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. He took all that we deserved and he gave us what he had on him. That was a beautiful song, and we thank God for the team. Hallelujah. It's very good. So this is a time of offerings and tithes, hallelujah, which are things that makes people uncomfortable. Hallelujah. I'm going to read a story in the book of Kings, 2 Kings chapter 4. It's a beautiful story there. So I'm just going to be very short. Hallelujah, praise God. God is good. Hallelujah. May I have my envelope? So I can also show that I also give, hallelujah. I don't want to show that I take, I also give. Because Jesus said what, the Apostle Paul said what, it is more blessed to give than to receive. 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 1, the word of God reads as follows. Now one of the wives of the sons of the prophet cried to Elisha, "Your servant, my husband, is dead, and you know that your servant feared the Lord. But a creditor has come to take my two sons as slaves." Hallelujah. It's a shame that this man feared God, but yet the creditor came to take the sons after his death. Verse 2 reads as follows. Elisha said to her, to the woman, "What shall I do for you? Tell me, what do you have in your house? What do you have in your house?" The woman came to Elisha and said, "What? Your servant, he feared God. He feared God. He walked with God. He loved God. But when he died, the creditors have come to take my sons as slaves." She was asking for help. But Elisha, the man of God, said, "What shall I do for you? What can I do for you? What do you have in your house?" The woman replied, "Your servant has nothing in the house except a jar of oil." Hallelujah. Your servant has nothing in the house except a jar of oil. There's always something to give to God, even though it looks like there's nothing to give to God. You know that boy who went to Jesus' crusade? Mom prepared a few fishes and loaves of bread. It was too small, but that is what God used to feed the 5,000. All of us, we do have something to give into the house of God. And a lot of time, we are believing for certain things in our life, but God is saying, "What? Release what you have in your hand so that I can give you what I have." Hallelujah. Because there's a principle. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Hallelujah. Because the one who gives puts God in a position to give him back. Hallelujah. Because one thing about God, God doesn't like to be in debt to anyone. And God watches over his word. You know, when we give to the house of God, we are not making the pastor rich, hallelujah. But we are obeying the principles of the word of God. And Jesus said what? Let us give. Let us give, hallelujah. So I want to encourage us that we should give into the house of God. It's very important to give into the house of God. Because when we give into the house of God, there are certain things that take place in our lives. Hallelujah. You know, when God flooded, I don't know if I'm misrepresenting God here, but when God flooded the former world, hallelujah, the old world with flood, Noah came out of the boat, and the first thing that Noah did was offer a sacrifice. And there's something that God said that is very interesting. When God smelled Noah's sacrifice, God said to himself, "I will never again destroy the world with water," hallelujah, because of Noah's offering. And that is every time when we see it's raining, we always see a rainbow, a covenant, something that God puts to remind him of that day, hallelujah, so that God should not do the same thing again. Noah's offering rescued us, prevented us from having another flood, hallelujah. Our offering can do great things, hallelujah. So please, let us obey God by giving our offerings and tithe. Yes, we do give our tithing. We do believe in tithing, hallelujah. It's 10%. The Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, He says everything that was written before was written for our examples, hallelujah. It was written for us to whom the end of the world has come. So everything in scripture is written for us. So I encourage us to be givers, hallelujah. It's very important to give into the house of God. It's really for your own benefit and my own benefit, hallelujah. I'm going to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. God is asking, what do you have in your house, hallelujah? The woman had a jar of oil, but what do you have in the house that you're going to give to God? Heavenly Father, Lord, we just want to thank you, Lord God, for your precious word, Lord. We want to thank you, Lord God, that you are faithful to your word. Even though the woman had nothing, hallelujah, but she had something that was too small, that she did not value, but that was one thing that you required, hallelujah, to bring miracle. I pray, Lord God, for my brothers and sisters, whatever offerings and tithe they bring here, I pray, Lord God, that you do mighty things in their life. You do so many things in their life, hallelujah. They're going to experience breakthrough because of obedience to your word. Father, Lord God, we want to thank you, Lord God, and want to give you glory in the mighty name of Jesus, because there is a jar of oil in our house, and we are bringing it to you, Lord. We thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. But we bring our offerings, hallelujah, rejoicing. Please don't be angry, Brother Prince. I never wrote the Bible, hallelujah. We are still reading the King James, not the Prince version, hallelujah. So please, let us give rejoicing because God loves a cheerful giver. May we get a song, please, hallelujah. A song, any song, please.
What shall I render unto Jehovah? For he has done so very much for me. What shall I render?
One of the pastors, but it's not the main one, hallelujah. In the words of our sister, we're going to invite the main pastor, Pastor Daniel, hallelujah.
Father, we thank you for this day. This is the day that you have made for us to be blessed. Amen. And I'm very, very glad because our pastor, our friends from Sofia, who knows Sofia?
Bulgaria.
I wanted to ask, where is Sofia? In Bulgaria. So, we are blessed today. Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am blessed.
Through my honorable friend, honorable pastor, Pastor David, that we known ourselves for many years.
Yes.
That the Lord has put us together to work for the kingdom. So we have been connected in Sofia, Bulgaria.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The church is expanding.
Amen.
So I'm going to invite Pastor David. That will introduce Pastor Tommy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I love this advert that said the friend of my friend is your friend.
Yes.
Yeah.
The friend of my friend is your friend. Amen. So Pastor David, you are welcome.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Thank you.
Tommy's going to play the keyboard. Somebody's going to play the guitar, so you can sit down. You can have a sit down. We're going to play some music to you.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Yeah, the drum.
Yeah? The drums can stop. You can stop. You can go.
You can go too.
I will use your cable, sir. My cable is not working. Sorry.
You're going to use your cable. Okay.
Yeah, my cable has a problem. I don't know why.
Well, it's my pleasure to be back here again.
Amen.
I believe you'll see me in a couple of weeks' time when you do your conference. That's right. So you'll be able to hear more of me then. Make sure you all come, won't you?
Yeah.
If you come, I'll see you. Unless you all go to the next meeting. But today is going to be a great meeting. And yes, you've probably not had anybody from Sofia, Bulgaria before. And I've known Pastor Tommy now for quite a few years, probably as long as I've known you, Pastor. And I've been to Bulgaria a few times. I used to go to Bulgaria every year, but I didn't go for 5 years. But I went again this year and we've seen many miracles. We've seen in Bulgaria many miracles. We had a 40-year-old man who was deaf-mute started to speak and hear, and a 20-year-old deaf-mute started to speak and hear. Two of the blind people started to see. Many miracles, wasn't it, Tommy? Many miracles, and you know, and God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, which is the same as our church. And God's the same in Colville and in Sofia and in Coventry. Believe it or not, it's the same all over the world. And I know Tommy is going to have a great message for you today, so I'm going to give him all the time. And thank you, Pastor, for inviting us. And we all know my friend here from Ghana. And he's still looking for a wife. You've not found him a wife yet, have you? Yeah, he'll have to migrate to Coventry, that's right. Anyway, Pastor Tommy, would you like to come forward? God bless you. You're going to play some music, and then Stefan.
Yes.
Where are you, Stefan?
I'm here, sir.
Oh, you're there. You're going to interpret, aren't you?
I will try to do my best.
We do apologise for being late, because they wouldn't let us in the car park.
Yeah, so many spaces,
we couldn't get in. But anyway, are we going to sing them a Bulgarian song?
Yes. Great.
Amen.
Tommy, I'm going to sit down.
Okay. There is a song that you know very well. I will sing this song in Bulgarian, but you can sing it in your language, okay?
It doesn't have right to scripture. I don't know who is playing to the piano, but the piano is with the transport.
It's not the same with...
Anyway, we will sort it out. Why this microphone doesn't work, I don't know. I have a problem from the morning, believe me. All the systems has a problem with me. I don't have a problem with the systems, but the systems has a problem with me. I don't have a problem with the systems, with the cables, but the cables has a problem with me. See?
Щото духът на Бога е в сърцето ми, а ще пея када ми. Духът на Бога е в сърцето ми, а ще пея када. I'm
Oh,
Jesus, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are for the first time in your meeting, in your church. How many of you are happy of your pastor, your church gathering here? Are you happy? Eh? And I believe that you will come in this church in next 10, 20 years.
Yes.
And we will begin a big meeting there. And the Lord will attend many people to your ministry. Okay, God bless you. I prefer to preach on Bulgarian language, and he is a very good translator. My friend Stefan, he knows 7 languages and can translate it. He is translated from Greek, from Spanish, from English, from Macedonian, from Romanian, Turkish, and what more?
Russian.
Russian.
I'm not good in English.
Yeah. But he will try to explain, because it's more easier to not to think for words, but to think for the sermon, and he is a good translator. So God bless you. What?
There is Romanian.
Okay.
I just know a few words.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, brothers and sisters, we are in one church in Bulgaria. Bulgaria is the eastern border of the European Union. Oh yes, I'm sorry. България в момента се води най-бедната страна в Европейския съюз.
Poorest country in the European Union.
И причината за това е комунизма, който беше 50 години на власт в България.
It was the communism more than 50 years in Bulgaria. It's power.
Знаете, че след като падна Берлинската стена и комунизма падна в цяла Европа.
As you know, when the wall in the Berlin it was fall down, then the communism fall down as well.
И спадна и от България, и вратите се отвориха за Евангелието и за вяра в Исус.
The communism fall down as well in Bulgaria, and the doors was open for the gospel to come to Bulgaria as well.
И ние започнахме вярващите да проповядваме навсякъде, и църквата започна да расте.
We become as believers to preach everywhere around the world and around Bulgaria, and the churches become to grow up more and more. Can you make just the microphones a little bit down, because the power is so much?
Yeah.
So this way is coming, this kind of voice.
Yes.
Because we are nearer to the speakers. Of course it's okay when we're singing, but when we preach it has to, you know, to be a little bit down.
So it's
because of the highest one. The highest has to be a little bit down. You know, the high, make it down, and you will not have this kind of voice.
След като се проповядва Божието Слово, Господ прибави много хора към църквата в България.
As well as we are walking around all Bulgaria and preaching the gospel, God multiplied the church more and more and more.
И хората започнаха да се стават много жадни и да чуят за Исус.
The people become to be a hungry and thirsty for to hearing about Jesus.
И за неговата любов към всеки един от нас.
They become to be hungry and thirsty for his life and his love to us.
И същевременно
in the same time,
аз съм основал няколко църкви, но
already I have built a few churches, of course, but the church that I in the moment I am.
Направихме един малък салон там в на 20 км от столицата.
We made like a small building nearly 20 km around Sofia, the capital.
И започваме да събираме.
And we come to get together to make meetings.
За около 20 години там.
For around 20 years.
И 2015 година.
And on 2015.
Дявол използва няколко души, които запалиха нашия салон.
A several people and they burn fire our building.
И цялата ни сграда.
All our building church has destroyed.
Единственото, което Бог запази, беше синтезатора.
The only thing that was survived it was the piano that was there.
И книгите на пастор Дейвид.
And it was your books, Pastor David.
He has some Bulgarian books there.
You have some Bulgarian books. Yeah, we'll come
to show.
Yeah, yeah. Which is good.
Everything was burning fire.
И ние бяхме толкова съкрушени.
We were so destroyed and so disappointed about this kind of action that was against us.
Но Бог ни даде сили да го преживеем.
But God has given us a power how to go through.
И започнахме от начало да
събираме. We begin from the beginning and again we start to get together.
И събирахме се на друго място под найем и започнахме да строим отново.
We rent some kind of a building, nearly small one, so we get together again and just become to be a church again.
И малко по малко построихме вече салонче, в което се събираме.
We start to build our building.
И даже Бог ни съдейства да построим и втори етаж с стаи за гости.
So we built our church and now we make another one level to have for the guests and visitors so they can sleep on the top of the floor.
Така че следващата година, като направим, може би вашия пастор ще дойде някой от вас, ще искаме да направим евангелизация из България в Гърция.
So next year when we plan to make some kind of evangelizations in Bulgarian church crusades in Bulgaria and in Greece as well, so you should come and we will have a sleep place there free.
Free. Yes. So, и сме много благословени за това, че Господ съществува.
Because God exists, of course.
И Той чува нашите молитви.
And He is listening our prayers.
И помага на сърце съкрушени.
And He is He's providing and He is helping for the broken hearts one.
А това, което искам да споделя като послание към вас,
like to share as a message to you,
което сме открили от опит в църквата Христова.
And already I was I have experience in this kind of things.
И сме разбрали, че има две основни неща.
We realized that has a two basically important things.
За вярващия през целият му живот.
It's a two important things for the believers from whole his life.
Първото и много важно нещо е.
The first one is
апостол Павел казва,
as apostle Paul says,
че на края на живота си,
when it was nearly to his death, to his finished life,
той опази своята вяра.
He said like this, he kept his faith.
И пътя извървя.
He was already walked the way that he's supposed to walk.
И сега за него е приготвено вече спасение.
And now for his is prepared the crown of the salvation.
Едно от нещата, когато повярваш в Господа,
one of the things that you when you become a Christian,
е да започнеш да развиваш твоята вяра.
Is to develop your faith.
Ти трябва и аз да растем във вяра всеки ден.
You and me, we have to grow up daily, every day to grow up in our faith.
Amen. Самият Господ Исус,
as Jesus Christ says,
Той много обича хора, които имат вяра, му имат доверие.
He loves the people that can trust him, the people that love him.
Когато християните ги е страх,
when the Christians has a fear,
Исус ги изобличава, че са неверни, както беше.
Jesus says to them, you have no faith. Why you have no faith?
Той ги изобличаваше, защо нямате вяра? Защо не вярвате?
Why do you don't believe? Why you don't have a faith?
И вижте, наистина е много интересно, Исус в лодката.
If you know the story, Jesus you know about the boat, the boat.
И той спи на възглавница.
He was sleeping in the boat.
И ние не знаем кой е Исус.
And of course we know who is Jesus is.
Той е царя на вселената.
He is the king of the universe.
И той всичките звезди, планети и цели космос е сътворил.
Universe, he was created.
И също така той владее има власт на природата.
And he has a power and authority for the whole nature that exists.
Учениците седат до него на 2 метра от него.
His disciples, his students, they were 2 meters near to him.
Но те нямат вяра.
But they have no faith.
Значи не е важно физически да си близо до Исус.
So it's not so important physically to be next to Jesus.
Вяра да имаш към него в сърцето.
But to have your faith in his heart.
И когато започна голямата буря,
and when the storm began to come,
те започнаха по човешки да изваждат вода.
As the humans they start to take the water from the boat to put it away. To take the water and just to
понякога християни,
humanity, you know, as a humans.
Когато християни ги налегне голямата буря,
as we know, as a Christians, when we have the big storms and we have
ние почваме по човешки да изваждаме проблемите от себе си.
We start as a human to start to take the problems out and just to speak about the problems.
В един момент те видяха, че всичко това ги залива и те ще умрат.
But in one moment they just realized that all the water is coming inside and they can die.
И чак тогава се сетиха да събуждат Исус.
then they realized, they said to themselves, we have to wake up Jesus. Then.
И го събудиха Исус.
And they just wake up him.
Тоест ние трябва да събудим Исус нашия проблем.
Of course we have to wake up Jesus in our problems.
И тогава той веднага скочи да им помогне.
And then he wake up and help them
immediately.
На време.
И бурята и водата и морето всичко се успокои.
And as you know the story, everything came down and the storm and everything was in peaceful.
И Исус се обърна към тези апостоли.
And he just turned up to them.
Които днес в тяхното име са построени стотици храмове. Can you imagine in their names,
they already built some kind of temples and you know things,
Рим,
churches,
други
in Roma and everywhere.
Israel.
Upon their names, they built so many buildings after that.
И тези апостоли Исус
каза, Jesus told them,
къде е вярата ви?
Where is your faith?
Защо сте страхливи?
Why you are afraid? Why you have fear?
Защо имате страх?
How you have fear?
Или с други думи, защо не упражнявате вярата
си? Other words, why you are not working with your faith then?
А само ви е страх.
And you just fear.
И това е пример за нас, скъпи брати.
It's example, brothers and sisters, for us.
Как когато дойде бурята в нашия живот днес,
when you have the storm in your life,
той ще ни каже същото.
He will tell you the same.
Къде ви е вашата вяра?
Where is your faith?
Защо не я упражнявате сега?
Why do you not put your faith in action?
В бурята.
In the storm, in the middle of the storm.
И ние какво ще му кажем? Господи, страх ни е.
What shall we respond? God, I'm afraid.
Ние винаги трябва да растем във вяра.
We have to grow up in faith.
И вярата в нашия живот трябва да пораства.
And our faith in our life has to grow up.
Това, което вършиш в живота, трябва да е с цел твоята вяра да расте.
As you work, as you act in your life, it is the purpose. The purpose is your faith to grow up.
И за тази цел има неща, които трябва да направим.
This why is a certain things that we should do.
В Римляни 10 се казва, че
In Romans some chapter 10.
Вярата идва от какво?
In 17 it says that the faith is coming through what?
Through what coming faith?
How the faith is coming?
Чрез слушане.
It is by listening.
Listening, yes. Not faith didn't come from eating. No. Yes. If you eat so much, faith will grow. No, only stomach grow, not faith.
Yeah. As we said, you know, the faith can grow up when you just build your faith inside, not just on the
Вярата не идва от ядене.
As we know, the faith is not coming from eating and drinking.
Вярата не идва от тичане.
It doesn't come from when you make exercises.
Вярата не идва от нищо друго.
The faith does not come from nothing else.
Освен от слушане.
From listening to God's words.
И то слушане на Божието слово.
You have to listen to God's words.
И сега ние вярващи трябва да знаем
course,
едно.
Today, the believers we have to know.
Едно от нещата, което дяволът постоянно краде.
One of the things that constantly the devil is stealing from us.
Е твоята вяра.
It is your faith.
И твоята радост.
And your joy, of course.
Защото като нямаш вяра.
Because when you have no faith.
Като нямаш радост.
And we have no, and when you have not joy.
Ти не можеш да събудиш Исус.
You have not. You cannot wake up Jesus, of course.
И той не може да скочи в твоята лодка и да помогне.
Cannot come to your boat and to help you as well.
И ти ще изпаднеш депресия.
And you will be depressed, of course.
И точно за това.
And this why?
Ние се обучаваме.
We have learned and we learn ourselves.
Какво да правим, за да расте нашата вяра?
What exactly do are we have to do to grow up our faith?
Най-важното нещо е да слушаш.
Is to listen.
Неща, които ще донесат вяра в теб.
To listen the things that can bring and bear faith in your life.
Друго важно условие.
The other one condition.
За да запазиш вярата си.
As you have to keep your faith.
Да се събираш с хора.
To keep
gathering.
Okay. To get together with people, to get together with friends around you.
Които ще ти носят вяра.
That can bear faith to yourself.
А не ще ти ограбват вярата.
not to take out your faith, but to bear a faith in your life.
Това е много важно.
It is most important.
Ако твоите приятели,
if your friends and relatives,
постоянно те осъждат,
constantly they just accuse you,
постоянно те обвиняват,
always they said you are wrong,
постоянно говорят негативно в твоя живот, always
speak a negativism in your life,
това ще убие твоята вяра.
It will kill your faith.
И ти ще се депресираш.
You will get depressed.
И няма да си щастлив.
And you will not be happy, of course.
И това ще те съкруши, може да те разболее даже.
And even you can get sick, of course.
Така че бъдете много внимателни.
So, be really careful about it.
С какви хора говорите?
With which kind of people are you talking with?
И с какви хора споделяте вашите мечти?
And with what kind of people and who do you share your dreams?
Това е много важно,
really,
защото така някой може да убие вашите мечти.
In the same way, someone can kill your dreams as well.
И вие да загубите посоката в живота си.
And of course you can lost the direction in your life.
Затова нашата цел като вярващи,
so our purpose, our target as a believers,
да ходим постоянно на църква,
is we have to constantly going to church,
и да слушаме проповедници,
and to listen the preachers,
които ще ни дават вяра.
That will give us a faith in our life.
Защото чрез вяра ние угаждаме на Бога.
Through faith we can make God well, or you know, he'll be happy.
Willing.
Okay, we'll make God willing.
И по този начин всичко,
way,
което искаме, може да го получим.
Everything that you're asking for, you can receive it.
Но ако нямаме вяра достатъчно,
but if we have not faith enough,
ние ще чакаме момента, докато вярата ни порасне.
We have to wait to the moment that our faith will grow up.
И всичко това сме го научили от опит, брат и сестри.
As we learn these kind of things by experience.
Четейки нещата в Библията.
As we read the Bible.
Много накратко ще ви разкажа едно свидетелство от моя живот.
Shortly I'm gonna make a... Thank you, Adam. Thank you. Shortly I will give a testimony. I have already water there, but really, thank you for your service.
Моя син се роди с много тежки болести.
My son get born with really sick,
has too much sickness.
I have two sons.
И втория се роди с четири тежки болести.
The second one has four sicknesses.
Първата болест беше главата му се пълнише с биологична вода, това се нарича хидроцефалия.
The first sickness he had when he was baby and he was born like this, his head had a hydrocephalia. It means the biologic water,
yes,
filling the heart, the head exactly, and it should be explored after that.
Следващото заболяване неговото сърце спираше.
His heart was stopping
for a minute.
За една минута.
За една минута, да. За някой път за 30 секунди.
Sometimes his start was stopping for 1 minute or for 30 seconds. His heart was stopping.
И докторите казаха, ние не знаем кога завинаги това сърце ще спре и няма да тръгне повече.
The doctor told me that we don't know when his heart will stop and will not start anymore.
И вижте, това е малко бебе кърмаче.
It was just a few days baby.
50 сантиметра.
50 сантиметра. 50 инч.
И сърцето му спира, тръгва.
Can you imagine? His heart is stop and then start again and stop and again start.
It's crazy. Следващата болест е...
And the next sickness that he had.
Имаше запушена жлъчка.
Как беше
жлъчка? How is the name of this?
Gallbladder.
Gallbladder.
He had a problem with the gallbladder.
No working gallbladder.
It was not working.
И той стана целият жълт.
And he become yellow all his.
Като това цвете там.
It's like this kind of flower that we have.
Бялото на очите му, ноктите навсякъде по жълта.
Everywhere, even his eyes and his nails, it was yellow.
И отиваш да видиш бебето си, то жълт.
Can you imagine, you go to see your baby and he's yellow all.
Yes. И последната болест
имаше
разкъсани черва.
Интестини. Интестини. It was blocked. The intestines. 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 I have to know this word, intestines.
Intestines.
Intestines. Has a problem with intestines.
И червата бяха дефектни, така са се развили. И докторите изрязаха 30 см от чербата. И след това ги залепиха. И това нещо го оправиха.
And of course they fix some of the things that
Но казаха, че всички останали болести те не могат да ги
целят. But they said all these kind of sicknesses that the baby has, we cannot heal him.
И започваме да се молиме.
And of course we become to pray.
Аз започвам да предлагам на църкви да се молят.
I already give a prayer, you know, needs to different churches.
И докторите постоянно казаха след две седмици детето ще умряло.
And the doctors always give me this kind of message. After 2 weeks this baby is dying.
След това минаха две седмици.
After two weeks
то не умря.
The baby didn't get.
И те казаха още 7 дни и ще
умре. Okay, after 7 days the baby will die.
След това му дадаха още 18 дни и ще умре.
Then they said after 18 days the baby will die.
И така и не умря бебето.
But the baby didn't die.
И след 5 месеца, 6 5-6 месеца.
After 5 or 6 months after that,
доктора казва, трябва да му направим втора операция.
The doctor says to me, look, we have to make one more operation.
На жлъчката.
For the gold bladder. I have to listen to this word. Yeah. And we have to make one more operation for the gold bladder.
И аз питам доктора, колко души, колко бебета умират от тази операция.
And I ask the doctor, how many babies are dying because of this operation?
И той каза 50% от бебетата умират.
And he answer 50% of the babies they are dying.
И аз тогава решихме, се молихме и Господ ни вложи в сърце.
And God put something in my heart.
Да не се съгласяваме на тези
операции. And we said we are not agree and we will not make this operation.
И изписахме детето.
And we took the baby home.
Подписахме декларация.
We made a declaration and contract that we don't allow them to make operation.
И почнахме в къщи постоянни молитви.
And we carry on to pray at home.
Пост, молитва.
And of course a fasting.
След 2 месеца и половина.
And after 2 months and a half,
занесехме го обратно в болницата.
After 2 and a half months, we have to go again to the hospital.
Направиха му пълно изследване.
To make the checks and you know all the things.
Всички изследвания са наред.
But what we think, all the checks and the results, it's okay.
И беше съвършено изцеление.
He was absolutely healed.
Слава на Бога.
And the glory is of God.
Сега той е на 27 години.
He now is already 27 years old.
Занимава се с музика, свири на китара в една църква.
He's playing guitar in church somewhere.
Също така е студент.
And now he's a student, of course.
И даже си направи фирмичка
and
за реклама.
And he has like a company that is for commercial.
И работи.
And he's working with his
и от тогава до днес
and from then until now,
не е боледувал от никаква болест.
Never he has sicknesses anymore.
Аз искам да ви кажа, че вярата прави големи чудеса.
This one thing that I would like to say, that your faith can do great miracles.
Амен. И понеже нямаме много време, другото, което донася благословение в живота ни,
the other things that can bear blessing in our life,
е нашия език, нашата уста.
Our mouth, our lung, our tongue, no lung, our tongue. Yes.
В притчи се казва,
it says in parables,
че смърт и живот има в силата на езика.
It says in parables that death and life have in the power of tongue.
Така че ние можем да използваме това за нашия земен живот.
We can use these kind of things in our daily life and our earth life.
Когато ти си вярваш, човек,
when you are believer,
ти преминаваш от властта на Сатана,
you are going from the authority or power of Satan,
под властта на Исус Христос.
You are going under authority and power of Christ.
Властта на Исус Христос е вечна.
Because the power of Christ is eternal.
Обаче ти трябва да внимаваш в някои неща.
But you have to keep attention in several things.
Трябва да се пазиш от грехове.
You have to keep away yourself from the sins.
И трябва да внимаваш какво говориш.
And you have to give attention what exactly do you confess, do you speak?
Защото ти си човек на Исуса Христа.
Because you are Jesus Christ persons.
И ти си човек на властта.
And you have authority and power in your mouth.
И знаете, че властта днес с една грешна дума може да се обърка целият народ.
You know the authority or the, for example, the governments with one wrong words they can make a mess in whole country. In one word.
Така и вашия живот може да се обърка от грешни думи.
The same, your life can be really destroyed when you speak a wrong words.
Първо много важно, не говорите негативно за живота си.
Do not confess, do not say a wrong and negative things for your life.
Говорете само положителни неща.
From your mouth supposed to come only positive things.
Или мълчете.
Or otherwise just be quiet.
Защото когато говорите yes, защото когато говорите негативно,
because when you say something negative,
има дявол, който ще изпълни това, което говори.
There is a devil and he will make in action what you said as a negative.
Когато евреите бяха в пустинята, водени от Мойсей,
when the Hebrews was in the desert leading by Moses,
те почнаха силно да роптаят.
They become to shouting out against God.
И мислят, че никой не ги чува.
And they think that nobody was listening to them.
И в числа, мисля, че 14 глава беше.
I think in Numbers it was maybe 14 chapter.
Господ се обади и каза чрез Мойсей.
God says through Moses.
Чух всичките ви роптания.
I have heard all your complaints.
И всичките ви страхове.
And all your fears that you had.
И всичко това, от което ви е страх.
And everything that you have fear.
То ще дойде върху вас.
It will come upon you.
И така е стана.
And as you know the story.
Изкочиха змии.
And you know they had snakes.
И започнаха да ги хапят.
They start to bite them.
И защо умираха? Защо умираха? Заради лошо говорене.
Because they had wrong spellings.
Ако сега мълчали,
if they were quiet,
змията щеше да ги подмине.
You know, the snake can go and just pass away somewhere.
Но сега, роптайки,
because of their words,
с това мърморене,
because of their
и те привлекаха змиите.
They just take they just with this kind of complaints they get a chance or authority to the snakes to bite them.
В този ден са умрели около 23 000 души от
това. 23,000 people has died one day.
Затова поуката, която извличаме.
What can we learn from this story?
Какво говорим е много важно.
It is really important what do you say from your mouth.
Имаме още време, ще ви скажа два такива случая.
Because we have more time, I'm going to share two cases.
Моите леле, имаме една леле в България. Има...
I had yeah. Auntie in Bulgaria. Auntie, you know what's it, auntie?
Yeah, yeah.
И тя беше православно вярваща.
And she was like a orthodox believer.
Обича да яде. Дайте, това не го превеш.
Okay. I will make it because he said she was so she want to, you know, she liked to eat too much and he looked me.
Yes. It's okay. There's so many people
like me.
We too. All of me.
Oh, yeah, me too. Yeah. This direction.
But okay, you see the story. I have another aunt in the relatives between them.
I have another one auntie.
Yeah. И те отидаха да се видят на гости.
And they get together, you know, just have a cup of tea.
И първата ми леля казва на другата.
And my first auntie say to another auntie.
Много съм дебел.
I'm so fat.
Защо да не ме хване един рак, че да отслабна?
Why do I to not be to have a cancer tumor and I will get thin after that?
Защото съм чувала,
because
че когато ги хване рак, много отслабвали.
Because I have heard some persons that are fat when they have a cancer tumor they get thin after that.
И другата ми леля също е вярваща и казва.
My another, the second auntie that I have, she is really believer, she said.
Как можеш да говориш така?
Stop. How can you confess this kind of words?
Ти си вярваща.
Because you are a believer.
Моля ти, не говори така.
Please do not say this kind of words from your mouth.
И тя отговорила.
But she respond.
Абе какво са това и ние само думи?
It is just a words.
It is just
a word from my mouth.
И тя била много възмутена, другата ми леля, която...
But my second auntie, she was really upset. Why she said like this?
20 дена по-късно...
And imagine, 20 days after that,
Първата ми леля се разболя от рак.
My first auntie became sick from cancer tumor.
И след още 20 дена умря.
And after 20 days more, she passed away.
Завинаги отслабна.
And she get teeny forever.
Така че когато не се харесваме, а вие какво говорите?
When you don't like yourself in this moment, don't just be careful what you confess.
Yeah, okay. Ти си хубав. И така, още един случай ще ви кажа подобен.
Yeah, and I will share one more case.
Едно младо момче на 18 годишно.
A gentleman, a young gentleman, around 18 years old.
И трябвало да влиза в казармата.
He's supposed to go to the army. You know, the men, when you are 18, you have to go to the
Bulgaria, yes.
To Bulgaria, in army. You cannot go away, you have to.
И той е син на една наша сестра вярваща.
And he's a son of our sister from the church.
И той започнал да си говори, когато се събрал в компания с приятели.
And when we get together, you know, when he was with friends, in his age.
И той започнал да им казва.
And he began to say this kind of words.
И правил така на краката си.
He said like this one. He made this kind of action with his legs.
И казал, краченце, краченце.
Oh, my foot, my foot.
Що не ми стане нещо?
Why do not have something like something?
Така че да не ходя в казармата на краката.
Something to happen to my legs, so I'll to have a reason to not go to army.
И всички му се смяли.
And all of them among they start laughing about it.
Но малко по-късно, излизайки на улицата,
and one more second. A little bit after that, when he's going to cross the road,
една кола го блъска.
A car was hitting him in the back.
В гърба и той се парализира.
And he get paralyzed half.
За цял живот.
For whole life.
Той не отиде в казармата.
He didn't go to army.
Но сега е инвалид за цял живот.
But now he's a disabled, paralyzed half of the body.
Не говорете лоши неща за живота си въобще.
Do not set out nothing bad for your life.
Говорете само вяра.
Always from out to go out faith.
Или мълчете.
Otherwise just keep quiet.
Защото врага знае
because,
как да ви удари.
Because our enemy, he knows how to punch us.
Амин. И понеже нямаме много време, искате ли да се молиме сега? Има ли някой, който иска за пръв път да приеме Исус Христос в сърцето
си? Ние
с пастор Дейвид и с пасторите ще
се молим за вас.
Добре, има ли някой, който иска да се препосвети на Исус?
Is it anybody in the house that would like to restart his life with Jesus again?
И чувства, че живота му се отклонил. Има ли
някой? If somebody just feel that, you know, my life is a little bit away, so I would like to restart my communication with Jesus.
И последното, след това, ако искате, ще ви водиме в една молитва за изцеление. Всички.
After that we can pray a simple prayer for healing.
Healing. Yeah? You want? Healing.
Healing.
Okay. Yes. Значи, тогава да направим така, да се изправим всички и аз ще ви вода в една молитва, вие повтаряйте на глас.
Maybe we can make it like this. Everybody will stand up on our feet and I will lead you in a simple prayer.
И след това, които имате нужда от изцеление, ще дойдат напред да се молим.
If somebody needs from healings, then you can come in front and we're going to pray for you.
Okay?
Tell me, let me explain it to
them better. Better. Okay,
well,
better English, please.
I'll explain it better to you. Is anybody in this room, you've never given your life to Christ? Because it's important. Because if you're not, then you're not going to heaven, you are lost. Is anybody who never gave their life to Christ, raise your hand now if you want to give your life to Jesus. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Ask the person next to you and say, should you raise your hand? Ask somebody next to you.
Should you raise your hand?
Ask the person. So raise your hand, that's it. Then come forward then, darling, come forward. one, just stay there. The other one is, if you've been following Jesus, but you know, you've wandered away a little bit, and you're not on fire for Jesus, then you need to get back. If that's you, you raise your hand. Raise your hand. Anybody? Everybody here on fire for Jesus, is that right? Everybody on fire for Jesus. You're going out preaching on the streets in a few moments, are you?
Amen.
So everybody is following Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. So, Tommy,
okay.
This lady wants to give... This is this lady.
Yes.
She wants to interpret.
She's Romanian. You speak Romanian.
They speak Gypsy?
Romanian?
Okay. Let's pray for them, and you can pray too, others. You want them?
Yeah.
Heavenly Father, I come before you, and I confess all my sins, and I said to you, sorry, Lord Jesus, forgive my sins. And come and live in my heart. I want to give all my heart to you. I want to keep all my life and to use me for your purpose. I want to bless me. I want to heal me. I want to use me to the end of my life. Amen. Okay. Good. Okay.
God bless you.
Now we wanted to lead you, all of you, for prayer for healing. You want?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And I will speak of Bulgarian. He will translate. Let's stand together. Yeah.
Can we stand on our feet, please?
Because all of us needs Jesus touching for healing.
The problem is, Tommy.
Yes.
Където
е проблем?
Can you just put your hands, if it's possible, where's your sickness or problem you have on your body?
Може да положите ръка.
You can, of course, if I have a problem with the head, I will put it here.
Да.
So if you have a problem, just put your hands where the problem is, if it's possible.
Да. И нека да кажем така, Господи Исусе.
Can we just repeat, Heavenly Father?
Ние ти благодарим.
We thank you.
За твоята изцелителна сила.
For your healing power.
За това, че искаш да съм изцелен.
Because you want me to be healed.
И сега се моля, Господи.
And I'm praying.
Докосни тялото ми.
Touch my body.
Премахни болестта ми.
Get away the sickness from me.
И ме направи съвършено здрав.
And make me completely healed.
В името на Исус.
In the name of Jesus.
Аз мъмрям всяка болест.
I rebuke every sickness.
Да се махне от моето тяло.
Get away from my body.
Сатана, махни се от живота ми.
Satan, get away from my life.
В името на Исус.
In Jesus' name.
Махни се от семейството ми.
Get away from my family.
Get away from my family.
Махни се от рода ми.
Get away from my relatives.
Get away from my relatives.
Аз, семейството ми и моя род.
Me and my family.
Me and my family.
Ще служим на Господа.
We'll serve to God.
Нямаш власт над нас, дяволе.
You have not power anymore, devil.
You have no power.
Аз принадлежа на Исус Христос.
I belong to Jesus Christ.
Аз поврем всяка болест сега.
I rebuke any sicknesses.
И всякакви образования.
Any kind of sick.
И заповядвам да напуснат.
Get away.
В името на Исус.
In the name of Jesus.
Напускайте.
Get away.
Напускайте.
Get away.
Аз съм изцелен.
I'm healed.
В раните на Исус.
In the name of Jesus.
Кръвта на Господа Исуса Христа.
In the blood of Jesus.
Ме очиства от всеки грех.
Has cleaned me from any sin.
И в неговите рани.
In his blood.
Аз съм изцелен.
I'm healed.
Господи, благодаря ти. Нека да му благодарим. Господи, нека да му благодарим. Господи, благодарим ти. Благодаря ти, Исусе, че ми изцеляваш. Благодарим и ти, обичаме ти, Исусе. Алелуя. Амин. God bless you. I feel the big anointing here, the Lord moving, and I'm sure that somebody of you was totally healing. If wanted, somebody wanted to testify, you can do it. So if not, God bless you. You are blessed children of God. We are so happy to serve to you, brothers and sisters. And we are waiting for you in Bulgaria next year. In June. Yeah? The biggest thing. Okay?
Hallelujah. Amen.